A special thanks to Ella Writes Fix Sometimes, Kate Marley, and Basement Prussia for helping me out with this video. Ella Writes Fix Sometimes has made numerous theories and posts relating to Hetalia that really helped me answer what I couldn't answer in this video. I highly recommend you go check her out. And Basement Prussia also provided me with some awesome resources for this video, including a scholarly paper by Theodore Alexander Sands. I think someone wrote a university paper about Hetalia, holy crap. Hello, my fellow Hetalians, and today I am going to address as many problematic aspects of Hetalia as I can. I have scoured Tumblr for as many arguments that I could find and tried to compile them here. It helped that there was a wave of hatred against the fandom, so I saw plenty of arguments. So, here I go. But before I begin, there are two topics that I will not be addressing in this video. This is because, first of all, a couple people already beat me to the punch. I think I'll link their post below. And number two, these are bigger topics, and if I do make a video on them, they will require a whole separate video, as there is so much to cover in these topics.
The show is literally called Axis Powers Hetalia. That in itself is racist.
I've been seeing this argument a lot. First of all, that's the name of the first season, or first two seasons if you're going off the anime, only. The following seasons are called World Series, The Beautiful World, World Twinkle, and the most recent, World Stars. It shows the war from Italy's perspective, not Germany's. And what side was Italy on? The Axis. That alone does not mean it supports Nazism. Germany wasn't the only member of the Axis. Do you know who else was part of the Axis at that time? Finland and Thailand, well, sort of. Before you say it's glorifying fascism, take a look at the main title. Hetalia means useless Italy. The show literally focuses on how weak the main character is. If anything, that is the exact opposite of fascism. People also seem to ignore the fact that the series pokes fun at war in general and is overall anti-war and anti-fascism. Also, while the first series is called Axis Powers, it focuses a lot on the Allies too. The Axis isn't framed as the protagonist. No one is, because Hetalia doesn't have a plot. It's just a bunch of random skits focusing on things like food rations, the type of weapons used, the inventions that came out during that time, and of course, the military fuck-ups that happened. A huge emphasis on the fuck-ups because real Axis propaganda would never depict its home country in a negative light. The goal of propaganda is to portray your side as the flawless hero. That's like nationalism 101. And Hetalia? Yeah, this wouldn't fly in fascist Italy or Nazi Germany. Another example of how the Axis isn't glorified is in season 1 episodes 8, where the Allies kick the crap out of the Axis. A.T. Stans, the author who wrote the scholarly article about Japanese glorification in Hetalia, notes that Hetalia does gloss over almost all of the war, especially the darker parts of the war. But if you were to watch the whole show, it's easy to realize the show is not about World War II.
The show trivializes World War II. It makes serious events like colonization and Nazism look cute.
Ella Writes Fix Sometimes answered this the best. This would be a good argument if Hetalia's tone was intended for serious discussion and historical accuracy. It isn't. If you actually read the series, you would see that Himuruya tends to avoid dark and controversial events. Instead, it focuses on the things I mentioned before. This is because the series is political satire and comedy. It is meant for poking fun at history. A.T. Sands describes the series as a collection of gags mocking militarism and stereotypes. Hetalia does not portray violence or accurate portrayals of history. Hetalia condenses history for comedic effect, but retains an anti-war sentiment by belittling wartime Axis beliefs. If it were to touch on dark events, that would be kind of insensitive because the series has a comedic focus. Another thing that Hetagrammy pointed out is how Hitler is drawn in Hetalia. Notice how he always has his back turned and doesn't show his face unlike the other bosses that we have seen. It's almost as if Himuruya went out of his way to not glorify him. Again, Hetalia is anti-war. This is why Italy is the main character. When the Axis and allies meet on the island, Italy is happy to make peace with France. Look at his reaction when he is first shipwrecked. Italy asks Finland to stop the fighting on Christmas by delivering gifts, and snow, apparently. The enemies even share their rations with one another when they're not on the battlefield. There are many more examples, but these are the main ones. As Illa writes, Vic sometimes says, the conflict doesn't dehumanize the nations. It's the conflict that's brutal, not the nations themselves. Look at how America treats the Italies during the occupation of Rome. Then there are claims of glorifying imperialism and colonialism. There's that whole thing where England puts a collar on Seychelles in the game and claims her as his colony. Well, I think this was actually the game demo, but anyways, this is still messed up. But do you know what else was messed up? Colonization! This scene is messed up. Colonialism was messed up. I don't really see the problem with portraying a messed up event in a way that is messed up. And then, do you know what Seychelles does after this? She kicks the crap out of him. This behavior is far from being condoned or trivialized. Seychelles isn't having any of it. And England gets what he deserves. This scene is meant to say, hey, England's a dick. And then there's this. And look at how imperialism with China is portrayed. It gets to the point where China eventually snaps and destroys everything. Many say that fighting over nations as younger siblings makes colonialization seem cute. That's kind of the point, but not in the way you are thinking. Ella Rates Vic sometimes says it best. Hetalia does this to portray the colonizing nations as children having squabbles. Their conquests aren't glorified. They're instead made to appear foolish, ridiculous, and immature. The humor genre restricts what can be depicted, so it frames its focus on belittling the idea of colonization by depicting these nations as children arguing over something stupid. And again, the nations are more of a cultural representation, more of a representation of the people rather than the government. There's even a comic stating that the nations have to obey their bosses whether they want to or not. And there are definitely numerous times when the nations have disagreed with their bosses. But this argument ties into the next one.
You can't have a series about World War II and not have it be problematic, especially not a comedic one.
Then there are the haters that think Hetalia is problematic because it doesn't show the bad things that the Nazis did. Again, the bad things that the Nazis did is common knowledge. You don't have to mention dark things that happened every single time you have a series that takes place in World War II. A World War II story can be comedic and lighthearted. The Czech film Divided We Fall is classified as a comedy and takes place during World War II. Heck, they even talk about darker subjects in that movie, and yet it's still comedic. But a better example is the American series Hogan's Heroes. The show is about American prisoners of war constantly outsmarting their Nazi captors. No mention of the Holocaust or other terrible things that happened because it's supposed to be a lighthearted series. It's a comedy show set during World War II. But alright, you can argue that since it makes the Nazis look stupid, it's acceptable. Let's take a look at a World War II film set in the perspective of the Nazis. Let's look at The Downfall. The movie is entirely based around Hitler and his final moments. Does it make me want to support him? Does it make me feel bad for the Nazis? No. No, it doesn't. Because everyone knows Hitler was a bad person. When we see Italy on the screen trying to sneak by England by pretending to be an elephant, and when Germany is perplexed by a gun that is easy to clean but can only shoot one bullet, it doesn't make me want to become a Nazi, nor does it make me forget all the bad things that happened during World War II. You can have a comedic series set in World War II. The whole world doesn't have to be dark and depressing. The comedy genre of the series constrains what Himuruya can depict, just like it constrains Hogan's Heroes. History is condensed for a comedic effect. by mocking the tools and ideas of war and degrading it to a minute-long gag. Through this, Himuria portrays how foolish and distasteful war is, and thus creating an anti-war image. Why is America white? Oh, that's so racist. Himuria didn't expect Hetalia to be a long-term thing, so he didn't really think too much about some of the characters' designs. Himuria actually said that he would have made Japan much different if he knew that he was going to make the series long-term. Therefore, he probably didn't do too much research into American race relations. Also, the entire world isn't an expert on American race relations like you believe. I don't yell at you when you don't know anything about Russia's crippling domestic violence problem, where domestic violence is pretty much legal now. So, the rest of the world shouldn't have to know everything about American race relations. Americentrism at its finest. Also, the series is based on Japanese stereotypes. This is a stereotypical Japanese-American character. If you look at American characters from other animes, they share similar features. Even the Olympic personification of America shares these features. While I do think he should be a little tan and have darker hair, this isn't our perspective, it's Japan's. Himuria does go into detail on America's formation, though, saying that he's more like an ingredient for a country at the time of his colonization. The East Coast in the 17th century is like a cauldron for the birth of the unique American culture, which may have been a sign. This basically says he evolved more into the title rather than being the personification from the very start like Iceland was. Several groups and cultures were present, which would include both colonizing powers and the indigenous population. If you look at a lot of Americans with Native American blood in them, if they are mixed, they hardly look different from Americans with nothing but European DNA. Some are even blonde. Being blonde isn't exclusive to being European. It's rather racist to assume so, actually. Seychelles is totally whitewashed. This is the only claim that is actually valid. First, let's start with the anime. The anime, or at least the first few seasons, gets a pass because the budget was shit, and the anime fixed this later. But they could have fixed it before the official game came out. You're killing me with this. Come on. And then there's some of Hima's early art. Yeah, no, this doesn't get a pass. This is the only thing that does hold merit, but at least in modern art, she has a proper skin tone, which probably should be darker, not going to lie. Then again, the Seychellois people are rather diverse and often aren't as dark as people from southern continental Africa, and their skin tone often varies between people because Seychelles had no native population until a bunch of French, Indians, and Africans settled there in the 1770s, so the population is a mix of literally everything. So there isn't really a good standard on how dark her skin should be. But we do know that it shouldn't be this light.
But Hetalia is based on stereotypes, and everyone knows that stereotypes are bad.
Not all the stereotypes that the characters are based on are bad. For example, France and China have a legacy of making great food, so they are excellent cooks. Both the Germans are good mechanics. Seychelles, a popular tourist destination, is incredibly friendly and hospitable to strangers. Estonia is good at IT. Thailand is always smiling. They are based on both good and bad stereotypes. And stereotypes are just that, stereotypes. They are obviously not true for every person. That's kind of the point of stereotypes. This series is meant to poke fun at stereotypes, not confirm them. Stereotypes are from an outsider's perspective. You need to possess a certain humor for it, and it isn't meant for everyone. In Hetalia, each character's nation is targeted for ridicule through its stereotypes. And Sans also argues that the stereotypes are not intended to create a sense of racial inferiority. You can have stereotypes in a show and have it not be incredibly offensive. This is done by making the series a satire or a parody. Now, if this was an actual serious series, then yes, this would be kind of offensive. But it's not. There's like no African countries in the series, so that's obviously racist. Okay, I was going to make a whole separate video on this, but I guess I will address this here. As I have stated before, Himuruya likes to stay away from touchy subjects. Why do you think there's no Israel in Hitalia? There's a big reason why a lot of countries in the Middle East and Africa are not personified. There is a lot of controversy surrounding the identity and formation of these nations. The current state of Africa today is a result of European colonialism. As a result, many of the current borders in Africa don't make any sense, and many of the nations deal with inner conflicts like tribalism. Many people don't identify with the country they are in, but their tribe. Before colonization, Africa was said to have looked like this. There are many ethnic groups in Africa, and during decolonialization, these groups were not taken into consideration. The same thing goes for nations in the Middle East. Why do you think Kurdistan is such a huge issue? Personifying these countries may be a way of supporting imperialism, saying all these ethnic groups in these nations do not matter. And trying to portray their history is hard because how do we tell what is what country? And a lot of Southern African history was also not written down, so a lack of material plays into this as well. This is why Himuruya only put tentative African countries in the video game demo, and why Seychelles, a group of islands, is actually personified. This is one of the least controversial countries in this area. Another reason why Himuruya doesn't have certain characters is often because he can't figure out a good design. This is the most likely explanation for a lot of characters that Himuruya has talked about or delayed in the past, like he's talked about making the United Arab Emirates and some countries along those lines, and a whole line of countries that have alpacas in them, but a lot of times he can't design on a design of what personality to take. This is exactly what happened with Portugal and why it took him so long to be in the manga. Hima was having a really tough time and had planned this character as far back as 2006, and Portugal wasn't released until 6 years later. Hima says he has never despaired so much about a character design before. He wants to do his best to create a good character, and it takes time. The same thing happened with Czechia and Slovakia as well as Luxembourg, and is currently happening with Ireland. Himuruya has been planning out Ireland since 2007, more than a decade ago. And designing countries as diverse as these with so many ethnic groups, it's just almost impossible. There are so many ways to get it wrong and almost no way to get it right. So yeah, that is why there aren't many African countries in Hitalia.
Well, then why did he personify India? Good question.
India's situation with its ethnic groups is also quite different from the tribalism seen in Africa. But all of that is another story.
Most importantly, India's situation with its ethnic groups isn't nearly as controversial. Besides, who is to say that this is the only India?
But that is a theory for another day. The people attacking Hitalia right now really don't realize how flawed their logic is. To prove this, I will apply this logic to another series.
Let's all harass everyone that is a fan of the show Hannibal. It is literally a show about a serial killer who eats people, and so it clearly glorifies murder and cannibalism. And that is all the plot has to deal with, totally. It's literally given in the title, guys. It's so problematic, it's literally glorifying murder and makes a serial killer into a sexy white guy, which is racist too, that everyone loves, and it is clearly trivializing this horrific crime. Clearly, all the people who watch and, God forbid, like this show must be pro-murder and pro-cannibalism. This is what creates serial killers, guys, because everyone in the fandom must think serial killers are so sexy, right? Disgusting. For those of you complaining, oh, it's just a series, need to shut up. Why don't you clowns stop watching TV or get better taste in shows? Have I ever seen it? Oh goodness no, I wouldn't want to watch something so triggering and problematic. I hope these clowns all die.
You see how stupid that sounds? You see how dumb that logic is? Even if Germany was the main character in Hitalia, and even if he expressed Nazi sentiments, he never does, it doesn't mean that the fans of the series are Nazis, support Nazis, or anything of the kind. It's the same logic as the people that think video games cause shootings. I hope I addressed the majority of the arguments. I tried to address as much as I could. If this isn't enough, I'll do a part two if I must. Again, you don't have to like the show. Just please stop harassing people for it and stop spamming our tags, please.
Oh, by the way, and to all of you lovely people that sent me sexually degrading messages, death threats, gore, etc., I just want to let you know that I don't care. I am an adult. A few nasty words aren't going to hurt me. However, I just don't want the younger fans in this fandom to be receiving the same thing, because I know not everyone can handle this. That is why this is so important to me. You can go ahead and spam my comment section all you want. I don't care. None of you are going to beat the person that spammed all 16 chapters of My Immortal. You might as well just give up now. There's nothing else you can do that can trump this level of trolling.
I hope this brings a better understanding as to why people like the show and why it's okay to like Hetalia. Hetalia does indeed have a few problematic things, but what series doesn't? I think as long as you recognize the things that are problematic as such, there shouldn't be anything from stopping you from enjoying the series. And that was one mark higher on your history test. Thank you for watching HetaFX. Also, my avatar is not a Nazi uniform, thank you very much. Do you know how many countries have had green uniforms? A lot. You reach so far.